What's up, everyone? YouTube, Facebook, wherever you are, hopefully all is well. I'm Wendy, and it's great to be back here at Hot Chix Cool Toy Review, highlighting some really cool stuff for you guys and gals out there. We highly anticipated this guy for quite a while, and he's finally here. Introducing the Iron Man 2 Mark II Armor Unleashed version, Hot Toys MMS150 1/6 scale figure. We missed out on some of the older Hot Toys Iron Man stuff, so we jumped right on the pre-order list for this bad boy. Anyway, this time around we get a slick chrome and grayscale slipcover over 4-panel window box, covered in detailed photography and clean graphics. Unfortunately, we missed the original Mark II, so we can't compare the two. Otherwise, everything inside is housed in the usual clamshell configuration, so the box looks great. We've liked all of the Iron Man packaging from the pieces that we own. Anyway, the Iron Man 2 line is pretty sick if you ask us, so how does this guy stack up? Well, let's find out. Out of the box and fully assembled, this guy looks badass. The finish on this piece is outstanding and the detail is virtually impeccable. Everything looks as realistic as you'd expect from a latest movie masterpiece installment. The Hot Toys Mark II is a meticulously crafted 1/6 scale replica from the live action blockbuster film Iron Man 2. And this might be the new Iron Man figure to top. This particular armor suit integrates the riveted style plating, which looks sweet and extra sharp in an aggressive way. This guy's articulation consists of mostly what you'd expect, including ball-jointed neck, ankles and wrists, universal shoulders and hips, and fully articulated hands. Everything that is standard except at the knees, which feature a split swivel ball joint combination, as opposed to their more recent double joint style. The more substantial change to the Mark II armor is the absence of any core crunch capabilities. The new Mark II only has a single swivel point at the waist, which is odd if you ask us, since it wouldn't have interfered with any other functions on this figure. It is expected that armored figures have slight limitations in the articulation department, and this guy is no exception. The swivel-only waist makes this guy very difficult to balance on his own unless he's pretty much standing straight up. So what's under the new Mark II's hood? A whole damn lot. Trust us, this guy is loaded. This beast is crammed with goodies. First off, we get an assortment of helmet and head sculpts, including the standard light-up helmet, a second helmet with a magnetic convertible faceplate with a sweet sculpt and paint job of Don Cheadle, aka Rhodey, no surprise there, and an additional convertible faceplate helmet with inner details and integrated neck mount. Next up, we got the multi-point deployable air flap system. This is clearly the most intricate back-mounted braking system yet, consisting of 12 individual panels and points of articulation. These things are as amazing as they are fragile. Back up front, you get the super bright arc reactor, which is activated via a switch under the brake panels. Over on the left side of the forearm, we have a deployable twin rocket launcher. The compartment halves split and slide open on a track, and the rocket hub telescopes outward on a stabilizer. Over on the right side, we have an even cooler setup. The entire forearm completely separates, half swung on a hinge and half on a slider, to reveal highly detailed mechanical innards and multiple moving parts, including a second and unique telescoping twin rocket launcher hub. We so appreciate this over the Mark VI switch out wrist rockets. Oh yeah, the switches for his repulsor palms are located on the inner bicep area. Finally, we come to his air braking system located in his boots. This time around, we get an upper and lower swing out panel, which reveal beautifully sculpted thrusters and painted mechanical innards. This time around, however, the innards along with the brake flaps are completely removable. Remember folks, this is extremely fragile stuff, so Iron Man must be handled with the utmost care. No pun intended. The Mark II comes packed with some pretty sweet accessories as well. First off, you get a second set of non-repulsor static fists, which we'd so prefer an additional pair of articulated repulsor-ready hands that could be balled up into fists anyway. Next up, we get a standard Hot Toys crotch cupper stand bearing the Iron Man 2 logo. Next up, we get this super cool illuminated LED base with the takeoff rod. And finally, we have the three-piece work table. This bad boy is made of multi-layered, thick, sturdy cardboard material. It has printed graphics on it and is held together with magnets. It makes for some sweet diorama and environment possibilities. And last but not least, this being the Sideshow exclusive, we got the additional accessory, which is the right human forearm and hand with the mechanical repulsor appliance. Damn, that's a lot of stuff. But wait, I almost forgot. It's what literally unleashes this bad boy and pushes him over the top. The armor unleashed mode. The Mark II has removable bicep, thigh, and chest armor plates and additional switch out boots to give this guy a completely raw and mechanical effect. This is the kind of piece we wish we had two of, because you're pretty much looking at a completely different beast using the Armor Unleashed features. If that ain't enough, the incredibly detailed unleashed footwear feature removable brackets to unlatch the boot halves, and there is a switch under the boot sole which ignites the repulsor rockets. The only thing questionable about this feature is that we might have preferred the electronic feature on the standard boots, or maybe one pair of boots that had all the features. Probably too much to incorporate, but hey, we're not really complaining. The bottom line, the new Mark II Armor Unleashed version is no joke. This will be many collectors' favorite Iron Man piece. If you're lucky enough to own this guy, you already know he's definitely a great addition and an incredible starter piece. He looks great, he's loaded with features and accessories for sweet display value and bang for the buck. The only kink in the new MK2's armor is the lack of any core crunch capabilities. Because of this, the figure is very difficult to balance in any type of dynamic pose without the use of a stand. This is especially evident while the suit is in unleashed armor mode. However, there is so much going on in the features and accessories department that this issue is quickly overshadowed. This piece is pretty damn amazing, and we can't wait for the Mark 1 version 2. Later, guys. Peace.